Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I've got an F3 race at Bathurst. We're in the fixed series and it's early in the week. It's Tuesday and my first official race of the week. Really looking forward to this. I love this track, but I haven't really done it in the F3 before. I've done the 12-hour race in the GT3s and really do enjoy the track. Didn't really know what to expect. Expected a lot of chaos at the start. Really didn't get any. But what I didn't expect and which we did get was a phenomenal battle. I think we started around like lap 2 or 3 all the way through the end of the race. So I hope you guys enjoy it. Super tight battle with the number one car. A little bit of contact, but you know, all fair play and just really great racing from start to finish. I really hope you guys enjoy this one.
Go. Incident in L corner. Looks like Taylor. Right side.
Just happy to get to the mountain safe. One trip through. 12 to go. Fight too much about some of these positions in the draft. We prefer not to get closed up to the guys behind, so I'll let some of that stuff go for now. Kind of not sure what to expect, quite frankly, with this car at this track, so just trying to keep it clean. A little too fixated on the car in front. Good lord. Where the hell did that dude come from? Did he forget to qualify or something?
Three. Yellow.
Patience is a virtue. Big gap there after P13. Clearly I do not have the splice figured out. I've done it in GT3 cars. This is the first time I've done it in Formula 3. Hey, it didn't get hit that time. Something tells me he's got some wing damage. Don't remember where that is anymore. I used to know. Yeah, he's gotta have wing damage. I mean, he caught me like it was nothing. And then ran into me. I'm guessing he's got front wing damage and now he can't pass me. I'm sure I was braking too early, but, you know, it's kind of his responsibility to figure that out, I guess.
Stick to the plan. Don't need to make it
here. No problem. It's a lot of concentration for me to get around this place on a good day. I feel like the top of the mountain is where I struggle the most. sure there's time there, but and then getting back on throttle as early as I can there. Never really did figure that out, even after 12 hours. Got a draft now. It is nice that you can pretty much just hammer down all the way through here after the first lap. It certainly helps. Tense back here. Kind of makes things interesting. He would have passed me easily if he didn't have any damage. And then I would have had a giant gap. Instead, I got this dude on my ass. Makes it more fun. Keeping JJ in sight as well. So he gets out, he just doesn't make a lot of progress. Now we're gonna lose time. Closer this time. He just loses it. Well, in that case, I think he straddled the center, bottomed out, lost speed. Him having damage makes this an interesting race.
Chris, halfway home. Sure looks good.
this time. I got a good run out of there. Too early. Yeah, I think what killed him last time is he got in the middle of the track here and just bottomed out. Lost all of his momentum. He's got to go all the way over. Oh, I made a mistake. Get interesting. I guess he's gonna stick with him. Okay. Okay, this will get interesting. Respect for that.
It's
no force elbow. Terrible. You should have it this time. He's got to have so much damage. Every time he gets over there, he just loses it. And we'll switch back. And I'm sure he's so frustrated. Laps to go. Thank you. Thought he was hanging back to get out of that dirty air. Give the guy a lot of respect though. I mean, there's so many places he could have just forced it. But if he doesn't have a run or a good overlap, like, he's backing out, going into a lot of the corners. So, massive respect for that, for sure. I think, also kind of by accident, he showed me where I should be braking going into turn one. Ready to go.
Alright, Chris, don't let this guy distract you.
Can't seem to get out of there very well. It's gonna be pretty good. See what happens this time. That's a hell of a move, man. I give that dude so much respect, it's not even funny. He was so patient for so long. Clearly he was faster than me. Had some damage. That was great racing. Massive respect. I made a little bit of a mistake. Went a touch too deep in the previous corner. Capitalized. Good form. See if I can get it back. I'm gonna have a huge advantage in the straights, I would think, as long as I can stay close through the mountain. Yeah. Bit of wash there. Damn. See if we can make any progress on him. We can hear the scraping just going through the middle like that. A little bit. Shot.
White flag, one more to go.
Gonna have to get close coming through the elbow. see what we can do. Need to get a good exit. Oh, God dang it. Darn. Alright, well, that was still a lot of fun. I'll take a top 10. Take a top 10 with some good racing any day of the week. That was a lot of fun, actually. I'm glad I joined this race. Good stuff. Come on, Jim. Shit. That was awesome. I swear, that's the one thing about crew chief that's super annoying to me. Alright, so let's take a look at this. Going into turn one. I don't know if, I don't know, maybe he just... Let's see, where did he start to break? Eh. I think I started to break a little too early. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe a little too early, maybe too hard. Maybe he went in a little bit and kind of see him attack in the corner a little bit more as he's a little bit more to my left there. But either way, thankfully, neither car was knocked out of said race. Let's see. Where is... Nope. Can't see if he's got any damage. Actually doesn't. Oh, he's bent. Yeah, he's bent up here. Doesn't look like too much. Maybe something on this side. It's hard to tell from the angle I'm sitting in. But yeah, it definitely had some damage. And you could tell every time he got up beside me, he just lost all of his momentum. So, unfortunate that was the case for sure. But yeah. Wow, that was an awesome race. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Lots of good racing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.